Scott, and we have breaking news out of Rio. It's another medal for Team Canada.
Yep. Congratulations to our women who just won bronze in rugby sevens following a heartbreaking loss to Australia earlier today. They put it behind them. They came out to beat Great Britain 33-10 and claim the bronze medal. We're going to have more on that shortly.
Let's return to Canada's latest victory in Rio.
Yeah, yee-haw, huh? Our women's rugby sevens winning bronze this hour. CTV Sean Leithong is in Markham talking to some rugby players there. Sean?
Well, Ken, up here in Markham, there's a big turnout for a rugby game tonight, but they had to stop everything because they wanted to watch the women's rugby sevens and see how they could do over in Rio, and they did very well, beating Great Britain 33-10, taking control of the match really from the beginning. But it's a very fast sport, this rugby sevens. The match is being done in just over 20 minutes' time, but there was quite a crowd as we had inside the hall here. Let's take a listen to how they reacted to the victory. There was about 50 people inside watching the match, and they loved every second of it as Canada seemed to be in control from the beginning. But some of the people who were watching were members of Canada's women's under 18 sevens team, and I spoke to a few of them to see how they felt about the victory.
It's such an inspiration. I can't believe this just happened. This is great.
I would say it's a great feeling, not to mention, like, everyone did so well out there. And after having some harder games, being able to pull it together, like especially against Great Britain and everything after their last game, was awesome.
Hopefully when that's our time to go, that we can go there and win gold, and it feels so good to have them. They have set the bar pretty high.
So women's rugby sevens has really taken the country by storm, you might say, because it was trending number 3 on Twitter today. People seem to love this event. And I talked to Steve Darley from the Toronto Nomads Rugby Club earlier today about what it is about this sport that seems to have captured everybody.
I don't think we have that available. That was Sean Leithong reporting live from us from Mark.
We begin in Rio, where the Canadian women's rugby sevens team has made history. After a heartbreaking 17-5 loss to top-ranked Australia in the semifinal, the Canadians came out strong against Great Britain to secure the bronze medal.
And an opportunity to stretch the lead to Ferrella. Ferrella in, and she touches it down. Look at the reaction from Bianca Ferrella. The smile says it all. Canada with an impressive start in this opening half of the bronze medal game.
Well, it was a dominating performance from the Canadian squad, winning 33-10. This is the sport's inaugural year, meaning the bronze is the first Olympic medal in women's rugby to ever be awarded. After the match, Captain Jen Kish spoke about the historic win.
I'm just so proud, and we didn't have the easiest start to our tournament. You know, we had ups and downs, but, you know, who has a straight path to a podium finish? And I'm just, like I said, I'm proud of these girls. We have grit, and I'm just glad that Canada, whether we medaled or not, that they were still behind us no matter what.
And CBC's David Common was at that action-filled game. He joins us now live. David, you heard it there. We have grit. I mean, what was it like for you watching that match?
Well, action-filled glory is exactly the way to put it. Lovely to see you there tonight. These women came onto the field and they just continued to pummel away at Great Britain. The thing that's amazing is only yesterday, Great Britain was the one who basically annihilated them. Same teams, different day, completely different outcome. Great Britain ends up fourth. Canada ends up with a medal. Now, as you note, this is the inaugural year, the first time in 92 years that rugby has been played at the Olympics, but the first time that women have played rugby at the Olympics altogether. And so a particular historic accomplishment for these women who pummeled through. It's incredible watching this. It's like watching a street fight going on the field, all legal and all friendly at the end of that match, but it is full on while they are on that field. There are 10-minute halves. That's special when it's in the final stage like this. Prior to that, it was only 7-minute halves. And by the end of it, I mean, as a spectator, you're exhausted watching them. You can only imagine what it's like for these young women who are on the field. All of them very accomplished. Incredible to see this. Incredible that they got to where they are and now to have won a bronze medal. Really quite something, and doing it with a 33-10 final score. Not bad.
And Canada has come through, defeating Great Britain 33-10.
The only medal from a field so far, women's rugby sevens. Team Canada dominated Great Britain in the bronze medal match yesterday.
I didn't sleep last night. Kind of in a fog right now. Our world is blown up. Our nation has fell in love with our sport, and that's what we wanted.
As one of the new additions to the Rio Olympics, rugby sevens has a little bit of everything. It's fast, dynamic, aggressive. Today, the Canadian women's team delivered on all those things, winning a place on the podium in the hearts of fans and history. Our senior correspondent, Adrian Arsenault, was there to see it all happen. Adrian.
Rosie, there are generations of Canadians who have been maybe watching the sport rugby sevens for the first time during these Olympics, meaning a first look at the grit and the love that goes into a medal like the one Canada got tonight.
Wide open spaces.
Their social media offerings alone made them a standout before they ever stepped up in Rio.
What's up? I'm Jen Kish.
The Canadian women's rugby sevens team, gregarious, fierce, and as close as a tangle of puppies.
Got my laundry. Got my roommate.
Captain Jen Kish typically wielding the camera off the field and setting the tone on it.
12 women take to the field.
Of their dedicated Canadian followers, few are more loyal than Jen's dad, Steve. He of the air hugs with his daughter, that's a staple of every match. She needs him, he needs her.
I'm so grateful to have my dad here. You know, I play extra hard for him and for everybody else who's battling the disease.
They don't shy from talking about Steve's health, cancer that nearly killed him. Being here now was no guarantee. That he is a gift.
She just says, Dad, you gotta be here. This is our journey together. It's like, you have to be here. And I said, don't worry, Jen, I'll be here no matter what.
A single dad who watched his daughter excel at all sports, but it was rugby that hooked her early.
It was the first game, and actually I was right there when she split her nose wide open and she's leaking with blood. And she goes, isn't this great? They're just gonna tape me up and I'm going back out there. I go, have at it, go. Do it.
He's alone in Rio to watch her now, but never lonely. In the stands, it is one big rugby family and Canada loving. Rugby sevens is fast and cool, and in the semi-final match against Australia, Canada didn't catch any breaks.
And it's taken by Australia.
That face said it all. So did the score. Decisive Australian win. No gold or silver potential for Canada, maybe bronze.
They're not happy.
Not happy, but definitely focused. A few hours on hold for a father on edge. Then, Canada versus Great Britain. Last they met, Team GB won 22-0. Somehow, the Canadians weren't in the mood for a repeat.
And now a great opportunity for Canada. It wasn't Ferrella, it's Paquin who scores.
They scored early, and their Canadian fan club got louder. Curiously, Steve Kish was not with them. Seems he couldn't take the crowds. He was across the field, as close to his daughter as he could get.
Here we go.
Wasn't always easy to watch. But momentum just picked up as the clock counted down. And in the last moment, with a huge win, Steve just about levitated. Getting to Rio, getting through Rio, was maybe tougher than any of them thought. So bronze is especially beautiful. Jen Kish very clear about what and who was on her mind.
I can't think of a better way to spend a father-daughter moment than sharing my bronze medal with them.
And then a bit of a beeline for the man who has simply always been there for her.
Is this what it feels like?
This, pretty much what the doctor ordered. Adrian Arsenault, CBC News, Rio.
Nearly 60% of athletes representing Canada in Rio are women, and so far they've won medals in the pool and on the field. There were some anxious moments for Savannah Dubien watching Canada's rugby team play today. The 18-year-old is a competitive rugby player herself.
I'm right here.
She's headed to a tournament in England next week to compete as part of Canada's under-20 team. She believes Canada's success today can only be good for a sport that she feels many just don't consider.
It's not a very well-known sport, and I think our teams around the world could get better if people actually knew about it.
And nothing can compare to the exposure generated by the Olympics. In 2012, Canada's women's soccer team took home bronze, and interest in the sport grew.
I think the big thing that I heard was just young kids wanted to play. Young kids had dreams that maybe years before they didn't have.
And when more kids sign up to play sports, Canada becomes more competitive.
So, I mean, the goal is to keep having success, because when your national team having success, your talent pool is really healthy.
And that begins far away from Olympic stadiums, where young athletes at a local level are inspired to chase a dream. Briar Stewart, CBC News, Edmonton.